三道沟子。
I said this last time I was here, like, while I'm glad they have a washout available because they require a washout, so they hire someone to wash the trailers, I hate that I have to be the one sitting here. I could just as easily drop this thing in the wash bay. They've got six of them that are empty at all times, and when the shag driver had time to mess with it, he could drag the empty trailer over to where he wants it. But instead, I got to sit here for 5-10 minutes, killing my time. I don't get paid for it, so it can get washed out. It's like, while I appreciate that you have a washout and I don't have to pay for it and I don't have to go somewhere else and do it, it's a lot faster than waiting at a Blue Beacon. It's still unpaid time that I'm just stuck here waiting. My unloaded trailer is right there. Like, all I need to do is go pick up the thing and get out of here. But instead, I'm waiting on a washout. It just kind of blows. Up a trailer here, it's too tall. Now to get my 30-minute break in, because if I stay below 20, it'll stay in yard move, which is not, it's kind of like on duty, which is off duty as far as the 30-minute break goes. I need like 8 minutes. If I can stop somewhere, yeah, I'll stop and do my bills and stuff. The cop pulls me over for that. I'm on a shipping road, not a main street or anything. Like, all that's down here is shipping stuff. I wouldn't park here long, but a couple minutes to put my paperwork and stuff in, that shouldn't be a big problem. Guy washing his whole truck. As soon as I started recording, he started washing his beard and his shit. There he is.
Last time that I felt safe, I can't remember where I was. But it was raining and the sky was gray, and I was on a southbound bus. Yes, I can't face out. I can't face out. First time I stood up, but I can tell you I did bleed. And then an angel wrote a letter to me that I have yet to receive. But I can't face all. I can't face all.
How you doing, buddy? You look a bit like a goober. First stop done. I only have like 2 hours on my clock, which is not really enough to get anywhere but like halfway to Chicago. So I'll go up to Dixon, which is about 30 miles up the road there. Next appointment in Gas City is 5 a.m. tomorrow. It's about a 6 hour drive. From here, it'd be about 5.5 from where I'm stopping. So I was talking to my wife when I came in here this morning, and I just didn't feel like talking. But it's lightning again. It's gonna rain again tonight. I don't know if I'll run into it or not, but I see lightning already. Anyway, let me get down to Gas City by 5 a.m. Get this thing delivered. Tell you what, they got me unloaded fairly recently, but if this isn't a hostile work environment at this place, I don't know where it is. First, they have you do stupid shit that no one else in the industry is going to make you do. Like, you got to take a picture of your tires shocked. Next time, I'm going to just tell them I don't have a picture phone, see what they say. Then on the way out, checking out, you know, there's a line, and a guy was trying to get it in the door. The door was open for like 10 seconds. And the lady in the office had started screaming, "We need the door closed." And she just said that like 3 times in a row. And the guy in the door couldn't hear her. So we were trying to tell him what she was saying, but she kept running her loud mouth and not letting anybody get a word in edgewise. Finally, one of the dudes just said, "Hey, we're trying to handle it, but you screaming about it isn't helping anything." all you're doing is making a bunch of noise so we can't communicate with each other. So just chill for a second. Anyway, I'm done till like early tomorrow morning. There's a truck stop down the road. That's where I'll be for the next 18 hours or some shit.